What's up, guys? This is Hal Hart back with another video. Before we get started, make sure you hit that like and subscribe for more video content. In this video, I first want to say that I hope you guys had a nice Christmas day and you were able to safely visit and kind of communicate with your families. We are working on the escape plan for 2020. We're almost out of here, maybe like 6 or 7 days now. I don't know when this video will drop. But anyway, let's go ahead and get into it. We are going to continue the rendering topics. I have got a couple of requests. I kind of took some time off just to for the holiday season, but I am going to try to get to those requests. You are not forgotten. But anyway, for this video, we are actually going over the single band pseudo color. Alright, so let's go ahead and get into it. I'll go ahead and double click my raster data here. We'll go ahead and go over to single band pseudo color. And in this dialog box, we have several options. I've already covered the min max value settings in another video. I already covered the bottom of this, the color rendering and resampling. So we'll stick to the meat of this function and try to make it as quick as possible. All right, so the first option we have is you can select your band to work with. All right, so this band or this piece of raster data had 3 bands, but we're going to use the first band, and the first band is going to be red. We can also select our minimum and maximum from 0 to 255 is what came with this, or what is in this band. 0 being the darker colors, 255 being the lighter, close to white colors. The next important thing is the interpolation. So we have different interpolation types here: discrete, linear, and exact. With discrete, it's going to allow you to form ranges. It's going to allow you to encapsulate ranges to a specific color. With linear, it's going to take the known value points that you may have in here and estimate new value points that need to be encapsulated in the image. With the exact, it's going to only honor the values that are within your color map. All right, the next thing, we already did color ramp in another video. Label unit suffix, let's go ahead and create some labels. We'll just click discrete here just to get some practice labels. The label unit suffix is going to allow you to put a description behind your numerical label. So if you have a numerical label here like this expression and number, and you're working with a specific project or specific job or need some kind of description, all you need to do is add that description here and it will edit all of the color map for that specific description. So let's say if our example was project 1. Behind all of our color map, we'll see that project 1 appear. Okay, now I usually like to put a space between my project 1 and the numerical value so you can see the difference. Now you can edit the color map individually. So let's say if you didn't want to edit all of them, you can exit that, double click, and just add it for one, project 1. Okay, so you can just edit one at a time if you want to. All right, let's go ahead and clear that up. Now, with the editing of colors, all you need to do is double click the color and you'll be able to manipulate the color here. If you want to edit this specific value that is represented in the color, you can double click here and you can edit that value to whatever you want it to be. Okay, so it's a lot of editing that you can do here. Now, with the discrete interpolation, like I said, it's going to form ranges. All right, now with continuous, it's always going to be kind of awkward with continuous because continuous isn't discrete. Continuous flows together. All right, so we'll change our mode to maybe equal interval. With equal interval, you can better see what ranges are being formed. In this range, it is 0 to 51 is encapsulated with this color. 51 to 102 is encapsulated with this color, and so on. So that is what discrete does. Gives you a range that is captured by a specific color. And it works well with equal interval or quantile here. Okay, either one of those two works well. But continuous pretty much throws discrete out of the window. When you think about discrete, you want to think about distinct. You want to think about unique or separated. Okay, continuous is not any of that. It's just one big color ramp. But anyway, we went over that. Label precision. With the label precision, if you're working with a raster band that's using decimals in its min and max, or within that file, then you'll be able to use the label precision to change the precision of your numbers to cut down on the decimals or the places behind the decimal. But that's only if you're working with decimals. This file does not have decimals, so yeah, I can't really show you that. Anyway, let's talk about these different modes. So in continuous, like I said, it's going to flow together. When you think about continuous, I like to think more about the color than the values. So what continuous is going to do is take as many colors and fit them into as many values and fit them into a specific color as possible. So with a discrete, you really can't see that, but if I change this to linear, and then if I change it to linear, what you'll see is there are as many values as possible all the way up to the maximum value. Look at the values here. 0 to 32 is encapsulated in our first range, and then 32 more, just like that, all the way out to the maximum value. And you can always adjust the maximum value if you want to. Let's say if I want to cut this down to 200, and now it's going to fit as many as possible in each of these just the same way, all the way out to 200. Okay, so we'll change that back to 255. All right, so that is the continuous mode. The next one is the equal interval. The equal interval mode is pretty much will be dependent on the amount of classes that you're using. So let's go ahead and cut this back to two classes. We have our 0 and our 255. If we increase the classes, let's go to 3. We'll see a 128 pop out here. Now, why is it 128? All you need to do to figure out why this happened is to divide the maximum value by the classes minus 1. So we will say 255 divided by 2. So 255 divided by 2 is going to be 127.5. And it just rounded it up just a little bit to 128 here. If we increase again to 4, it's the same math. You would divide by 3 here. So it'll be 4 minus 1 is 3 divided by our maximum value. Right, so the next thing we have here is the quantile. So with the quantile, let's go ahead and knock this back to 2. So we have 0 and 255. And then if we go up 1, we see a 122 pop here. So why is there a 122 here? Well, when you think about quantile, you need to think about distribution. Distribution of the values of your pixels. Okay, so whenever you're dealing with your distribution, you will always have outliers, and then you will have an area where the majority of the values land. 122 is the average where the majority land. And how else can we know this? Well, I can go out here to my information tab, and I can see the statistical mean for this specific raster band. Okay, the specific mean is 121. If I look over here at the mean or the average here, it just rounded up just a bit. Okay, if I was using band 2, we will see that the mean would land around this 119 area. If I was using band 3, we will see our mean would land around the 120 area. So that's how you do that. If your classes are on an even number, it will split it will divide the right and the or the upper bound and the lower bound areas into two. So if I take this to four, we'll see that split there between the two points. If I take this to five, we'll see our mean again. Take it to six, if we get a split, take it to seven, we'll see our 122 mean again. Now, to apply any of these settings, all you need to do is apply, and you'll see the change out here on your map. Okay? I think I went over everything except clip out of range values. So clip out of range values is going to allow you to clip anything that is outside of the maximum value here. Okay, maximum or minimum. Like if I change this minimum maybe to 55 or something like that, it would clip whatever's not being used. We have a couple more buttons here that we can go over. So you can actually load a color map from a band. So if your raster data comes with the color map, then you can load it from the band. How do you know that? You just click it. And if it doesn't come with one, it'll say the color map for band one has no entries. So there's no entries on this band. You can also load a color map from the file. So if you create a color map in here, you will be able to export it to a file and you can send it to somebody. You can use it for later for a different map or whatever you want to do. Here is the export. So you can export, you can click that and export it to wherever you want to on your computer here. Alright, so I think I covered everything with the exporting and importing. Already covered all of that. I think the last thing I need to talk about was the different types of interpolation. You have two pretty much umbrella words for interpolations. So you have your exact and your inexact interpolations. Your discrete and your linear here would be classified as inexact interpolations. Your exact interpolations will respect or honor exactly the values that are placed within your color map. Okay? The inexact will capture outliers. So let me show you an example. Let's say if I got rid of all these, let me just copy, I mean not copy, but select all of them and hit the delete here. I thought I deleted that. All right, and let's say that I enter some exact values that I want, and I'll go ahead and switch the interpolation to exact. So it won't do that. Delete those right there. And I'll go ahead and let's say I want three values here. And let's give it 10. Okay, and as you can see, it'll automatically sort or order your values from least to greatest. And we'll give it 15. And we'll give it 20. Alright, now I want these values exactly. Now, do you see what happened up here with my minimum and maximum values? It automatically changed my minimum to the least and automatically changed my maximum to the greatest pixel value. So I'll go ahead and set some colors here to follow. So hit OK there. 15, it can be this color. Okay, so now we have our exact values we want to find. And I'll go ahead and hit apply here. And apparently these are not within the realm of that mean because there are not a lot of them. So let's remember our mean. That mean value was 122, right? So let's get closer to that 122. Let's do 100. So that'll be closer. And let's do 200 and 130 there. All right, now let's see what happens over here if we hit apply, because we're closer to the mean, remember? So the mean was 122. Now we're all around the mean, and you can see it has found various pixels. It has interpolated the exact. So basically, if you see this color, it is exactly 100. If you see this color, it is exactly 130. There are no ranges here like with the discrete value or with the linear value. Okay, hopefully that makes sense. If you have any questions or comments about using the single band pseudo color, please let me know in the description, in the comment section. And I will be adding to the description some links to further explain. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And as always, we're coming to a new year. Let's continue to grind. Let's continue to work. And I will see you in the next one. Peace.